The nation of Canada is about to be the site of a brand new volcanic eruption. However, this will not occur from what are traditionally thought of as its volcanoes such as Mount Garibaldi, Mount Aziza, or even the Iskut-Yunik river cones. Instead, this likely coming eruption is expected to occur underwater, specifically 240 kilometers southwest of the closest populated place, Hesquiat on Vancouver Island. There, at approximately 2,500 meters or 8,200 feet depth, are a series of lengthy north-northeast trending ridges. These mark a section of a tectonic plate that is slowly spreading apart, with the specific section deemed likely to produce an eruption being known as the Endeavour Segment. Its latest unrest began around March 6, when 200 earthquakes struck in rapid succession in only an hour, and before the day was over, more than 2,000 earthquakes had been registered. The largest of these earthquakes was a magnitude 4.5, but it occurred too far away from land to be felt by any people. While earthquake activity has since decreased, it remains elevated, indicating that soon a section of this mid-ocean ridge will spread apart as a mass fairly quickly. This will allow magma from the mantle to intrude upwards before fusing on the ocean floor and forming a new massive oceanic crust. The aforementioned process is how new oceanic crust is created before eventually getting destroyed many millions of years later in a subduction zone. Earth has an estimated 65,000 kilometers in length of mid-ocean ridges which create new crust, which every year on average emplaces 20 cubic kilometers of lava that creates 2.7 square kilometers worth of new crust. If you ever took a geology course in school, you might be wondering how exactly a mid-ocean ridge can only produce intermittent eruptions, as many textbooks display a mid-ocean ridge as continuously spreading apart. After all, the rate at which mid-ocean ridges spread apart each year is often cited as between 1 and 20 centimeters depending on the exact tectonic plate boundary. While this figure is correct, it merely states a long-term average. In reality, segments of mid-ocean ridges largely move in geologically frequent but spaced bursts of activity as stream is released, meaning that sizable underwater volcanic eruptions occur at a select few locations on these ridges every year instead of along their entire length always erupting. In the case of the Endeavour segment, this mid-ocean ridge, which represents the diverging of the Pacific plate and the Juan de Fuca plate, last produced an eruption between 1999 and 2005. The earthquake swarm that was recorded on March 6th followed a slow but steady increase in activity from the same region which began in 2019. These earthquakes mark the release in stress and slow spreading of the crust which will soon give magma a path to the ocean floor. However, when exactly the seemingly inevitable eruption, which still might not occur by the way, takes place could range anywhere from a few days to several years from now. Yet, if and when it does occur, scientists will likely visit the erupting region via submarine to record a process which is not often directly witnessed. Mid-ocean ridge eruptions account for 75% of the 80% of submarine volcanic eruptions which occur each year, and due to their remoteness are largely understudied. Thankfully, in my opinion, there are no dangers such an eruption will pose to anyone in the United States, Canada, or beyond due to it being completely effusive, confined deep underwater, and far from land. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to support this YouTube channel. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Lillian Breen, for supporting this channel.